Welcome in Vendeuve for this day four of the World Super 6. We already had three awesome days. We are quite at the halfway of this World Super 6 2024 here in the northeast of France. In a few seconds, the first game of this day four between Italy and China. China played yesterday night against the USA with a 3-1 loss, which means currently that we have our favorite for this week, the USA. They won three out of their three first games. Well, we had an awesome clash yesterday night with the USA, now standing as favorites.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting today to see how China will react after this loss versus USA. The two teams currently on the court are coming here with only one loss on the same score, one set to three, also for Italy versus USA, but two wins for these two teams.
Yeah, and Italy had a very good game yesterday, defeating Canada. As you can see, that's the results of yesterday, Thursday. Italy won 3-0 against Canada. Brazil won 2-0 against the host country, France. And then the last game, we already talked about this one, with the USA winning. Which means when we have a quick look at the ranking, the USA are staying first with 9 points. China and Italy at second and third, which means the winner of today will take an option on the second place. Then Brazil and Canada, 3 points, and France for the moment, no points for today. At 2:30 in a few minutes, Italy against China. Then at 6 p.m., France against the USA. And our night session, the final game, Canada against Brazil. Another important game, because Brazil and Canada both have 3 points. We are, of course, already looking forward to the Sunday finals to see who will be in the gold medal final.
And the Chinese players cheering in front of the camera, so we can notice that Patrick Venturini, the president of the organizing committee and the president of Vendeuvre-les-Nancy Pro Volleyball Club, also is one of our cameramen today. Thanks to him, yeah, he is on screen right now, trying to find the best place to provide us with the best images for the live stream.
It's not always that you see a club president holding the camera like this one. But he's doing it, and both teams are no on court. And as you know, in an international event, the tradition is to have the national anthems of both countries, Italy and China.
D'être silencieux, merci. Please rise for the national anthem to Italy.
And we start with Fratelli d'Italia for Italy. Last year's European champion are ready for this clash against a very strong Chinese team. They only lost 3-1 yesterday night against the USA, national anthem of China. China, two-time runner-up in the most recent Paralympic Games, both in 2016 in Rio and 2021 in Tokyo. What can we expect, Ellen, from this game? Well, it sounds like China should be favorite from what we saw until now, but Italy was a very good surprise yesterday afternoon against Canada.
Yeah, indeed, they delivered a quite convincing performance versus Canada. So Canada maybe had not the best roster they could have. Anyway, doesn't take anything from the great performance by the Italian squad.
Yeah, Canada is missing Jennifer Oak. She's back home in Calgary. And that's for sure a big loss for the Canadian side that we'll see any later today. They will be taking on the USA in the very last game of today. But we'll be first focused on this first game between Italy and China. With an uncommon starting time, just because we have a lot of schools in the stand to watch this sitting volleyball game. You see a lot of smiles on the Chinese side. Wasn't quite the case yesterday night.
They don't seem too disappointed after this loss versus the USA. They are a big, big opponent for the gold medal in the upcoming Paralympic Games in Paris. China, two-time silver medalist in these Paralympic Games, three-time Paralympic champions before. Italy ranked 6 in Tokyo for their first appearance in the Paralympics.
Yeah, we have to say sitting volleyball is a very recent discipline regarding women's sitting volleyball, only since Athens 2004. And both referee of this game, Gigi Prieto, USA, Emma Vatteridge from Slovenia. And you know it now, it's a very first time in the world that we have the video challenge on an international sitting volleyball game. This one will be managed by French guy, Pierre Clebage.
Always. No, just taking care of the first referee, bringing some water to Gigi Prieto.
Yeah, he's always quite smiling and happy to be here. And we'll see in a few seconds who's starting 6. To see if there is any surprise. Rafaela Battaglia wasn't even on the bench yesterday.
Yeah, she's back in the roster. Will she be on the court?
And that's the question.
We have the setter with number 1, Julia Belandi, with number 4, Roberta Pedrelli, number 5 and captain, Francesca Bozio, number 6, Eva Cecatelli, number 7, Sara Cirelli, number 8, Flavia Barigelli, and the libero with the number 18 is Silvia Biasi. It's been Battaglia, one start.
Which is quite a surprise. Also, Giulia Arrighieri is on the bench. She played really well yesterday, but because of the rule of the VS2, they decided to put Sara Cirelli as a middle blocker.
Who is also a very good player.
Yeah, for Rafaela Battaglia, for sure there is no reason to change anything for Italy since they won 3-0 yesterday against Canada. And also a change in the Chinese starting 6 with Liu Hongqin. She came in yesterday during the game. She's in the starting 6 today.
Yeah, and Li Ting on the reverse is on the bench for China.
And that's a substitution we saw yesterday night during the game against the USA. And Su Yumin decided to have the same starting team than the one that finished the game yesterday night. Probably to find some connections. It's the very first game of day 4 of this 2024. Women's World Super 6 is about to start. In such a great atmosphere here in Vendôme, and Flavia Barigelli for the first serve. And the first part from China with Liu Hongqin.
First aim for the Chinese setter.
She's the oldest player in the roster with 43 years old. A lot of experience.
On the Italian side, Eva Cecatelli is the oldest one with 50 since the beginning of May. And I think she's the oldest player among all teams in Volleyball NOC.
Whistle again, Cirelli. She was over the 2 meter line, but sitting in the back row and couldn't spike it that close from the net. Cecatelli, digged by China.
And blackout found by Francesca Bosio from the middle of the court, which is not very easy. Strong hit by the Italian captain.
Italian
scored the first point.
Italian setter Giulia Bellandi. She was our MVP yesterday afternoon in the game against Canada. That's a missed dig by Silvia Biasi. The spike looked maybe a bit too long, because she was pretty deep in the court and still playing it.
You're not sure whether your block has touch or not the ball. It's better anyway to try to play it.
No blocker on the line, and that's a good try for Francesca Bosio. For sure, Italy has a lot of confidence after the win yesterday. That's a good one. But even with a one-hand set, Wang Yanan is able to score this one. This Chinese team is really very skilled in all the individual skills. Good reception. And good cover. Cirelli. Free ball in the middle of this Italian fire camp.
And both Bosio and Cicatelli are apologizing for not trying to defend this ball, but that's exactly what you're looking for when playing the ball smack in the middle of the court.
Touched by the Chinese side, but also by Jean-François Riello, our line judge for this one. See it? He takes it in his right shoulder. That's a good save for the communication team sitting just behind. Get ready for the transition set. Bellandi for the spike. Great block by Cirelli. And Italy is clearly in contention in this game beginning. Only one behind. 5 points to four for China.
Net fault whistled by Emma Votaric, the Slovenian second referee of this match. Against, I think, Chinese number nine, Zhang Shufei. The ball touched the antenna, and the spike by Shufei.
And Italy is now in front.
Italy 5, China.
Gigi Prieto, his first referee from the USA.
Oh, great serve.
We like this one in position four. Nobody was sitting there.
And China is immediately adjusting with Zhang Lijun coming at the net. Try to block the serve.
It was a good free dig by Francesca Bosio, but then Cecatelli was moving on the other way and unable to cover it. We can have one additional word on today's format. It's day four of this round robin stage. Tomorrow will be the last round, and then on Sunday we'll have the finals. We will have all the calculation of the ranking underway this afternoon and tomorrow to know what are the games that we will have on Sunday for the last day of this Super Six. Yeah, good reception. Bozier,
oh, what a spike right from Francesca Bozio.
Italy is still in front. Another good one. That's a good block by Wang Yanan. And for sure, this one is allowed in sitting volleyball to block the serve.
And then she touched the ball.
Because
again, but she was very cautious not to put her hand in the Italian side.
Bozio once again. Suisao too far away to dig this one. There was absolutely no blocker in front of Bozio.
Bozio is also a very skilled and very technical player. She can either hit strong or have a soft touch, a wall shot. And she used them on purpose.
This ball is pulled out. Oh, good, great, do great, Biasi. Italian is playing their way, and they force China to call a first time out.
Time out for China. Allez, je vais faire un petit tour, allez vous voir si vous êtes chaud.
Italy won the first game against France
on
Tuesday. We were quite sure of their level. They lost 3 sets to 1 against the USA in day 2, and yesterday this 3 sets to 1 victory against Canada. Well, Italy is clearly a very dangerous side, and they will play tomorrow against Brazil for a game that isn't decided yet. China has now this game, and they have quite an easy game tomorrow facing France, the host nation. A bit weaker still, but host nation and part of the Paralympics also. A good timeout for China, able to side out this one. And Zhang Yijun. She's a great server. Looking to find the best position in the best line. It's Chen Bozio. The rally. Lucky dig, but China has it. And great block out found by Xu Yixiao, Chinese captain.
She was the best attacker in World Cup 23.
Biasi. Galambi has to move. And another great spike. That's 2 in a row for Xu Yixiao.
In a very narrow angle.
And as it stands, 11-0, touched by the Italian block. Nothing to do. And timeout called by Amaury Ribeiro. I love the discussion we had just before the game. You told me he was discussing with Guimarães, the Brazilian coach, so he apparently speaks a bit of Portuguese.
Obviously, as he is Brazilian, he used to be a very good volleyball player playing for Brazil, the national team. And he just won a gold medal at the Olympics in Barcelona in 1992. So yeah, obviously he knows a little bit about volleyball. And clearly he knows Fernando Guimarães, little brother of Zé Roberto Guimarães. Fernando Guimarães, the coach of the Brazilian sitting volleyball team here in Bordeaux-Volley-Nancy.
And was he coached by Zé Roberto winning this goal in Barcelona?
Yeah, exactly, because Zé Roberto, the legendary Brazilian coach, won gold in the Olympics with the men team in 1992, then twice with the women team.
That's a lifting whistle against Flavia Baragelli. Get ready for the transition set. Smart play by Bozio. She wasn't in the best position in this one. Very from the outside.
It's always the right gesture at the right moment for the Italian captain. And apparently the pupils of Volley-Nancy appreciate the show they're watching right now.
I'm trying to figure out if they're supporting Italy or China, but they look happy each time a point is scored.
Anyway.
Fourteen for China, 12 for Italy. They'll be fighting this one on the other side of the net. And another great one by Sui Xiao. Just too high for the Italian block currently. And that's a first mini break for China in this first set. Piccatelli. Bellambi scoring with the left arm.
Yeah. As in volleyball, a left-handed setter is a good thing because it allows you do this kind of action. Very dangerous.
Set too much to the inside. Cirelli.
And the lifting whistle.
Against China?
Yeah, against Yu on King when blocking. So you may repeat that when playing sitting volleyball, when being in contact with the ball, your butt must also be in contact with the ground.
And Belendi is carrying on her streak. She had a great one yesterday against Canada. Italy was led in the second, 18-24, and she came back to give the set to Italy, 26-24. Gigi Prieto requesting some mopping action. Where? That's a yellow card for
the mopper? No. Maybe for the Chinese side, I don't know. Anyway, it's strange to delay the game when you are the one serving, but...
That's not very good for the yellow card race, but we don't know who got this one. Or let's say the Chinese staff.
Let's have... Bai Zhang Lijun. Let's have by Pedueli.
All played by Sui Chao. She's so good at this moment to find block out. Look at this one, a perfect set. And Eva Cecatelli.
Yeah, she had some harsh time yesterday night in front of the very tall US block. Things are easier for today. I touched the antenna too bad because it was a great spike by Eva Cecatelli.
A lot of team will struggle against Catherine Bolton. She's sitting at the front row. And a timeout for Italy. Because the gap is quite big now. Italy is 3 points behind. They're clearly able to fight back. But Amaury Ribeiro needs to make some adjustments with the team.
It's very important for Italy to see what they can do versus China, as the two teams will be in the same pool at the Paris Paralympic Games, in Pool A, with also the USA and the host nation France. But it means that Italy, if they want to go for a medal and to reach a semi-final, have to beat either China or the USA.
Oh, it works pretty well when they have this soft spike in the middle of the court. And both coaches have to manage with this big noise in the arena. Biasi. That's a free ball for Italy. Good option to build something. Ceccarelli dig. Another free ball. Ceccarelli once again. And this time, receiving it.
Great play. At the end of this long rally, it gets more and more difficult for the Chinese defenders to slide fast. A very clever play. Play of Cecatelli.
This block looks good, and that's a lifting whistle against China. It looked like they were winning this one, but that's a lifting call against Wang Yanan. Oh, Gigi Prieto is pretty touchy today with the lifting. Oh, this counter block by Cecarelli. No, by Cirelli. And she scores it. How crazy. And the comeback is underway. Italy is one in front.
But she had the opportunity to set to one of her teammates. She decided to spike directly on that was a good option.
Time out for China. Italy is taking the lead. Maybe at the best moment of this first set.
Alors attention, ça va être à nous. Attention, vous allez faire du bruit. Allez, encore plus de bruit.
And they do it once again. They already had this amazing game yesterday against Canada. And as we mentioned, Italy is increasing their level each year. Tactical serve by Bozio. And the points is for China. It was lacking just a very short second to have this point to be replayed. For Italy, 19 for China. And experience Eva Ceccatelli to serve. But the deep one. He's digging it. Oh, Chiarelli, very strong block. And that's a smart fight in between the blockers from Zhang Yijun, and she wasn't even close to the net. What a great spike. Well, this set wasn't good by Belandi, and the net fault is called against. Roberta Pedrali, 21-0. Song Shufei. Chinese number 9. Belandi for Pedrali with a strong spike. This one comes back any faster. Bozio fighting this one back. That's a free ball for China. Chiarelli for the transition set. And the blackout found by Roberta Pedrali.
We mean the Chinese coach getting mad. And Tang Shumei, he decided to have this little set instead of hitting the ball.
Yeah, good serve. And strong spike by Zhang Yijun. Perfect set by Wang Yanan. 22-0. Along the moving to set this one. And a 23rd point for China. The 2 meter line. And that's an equalizer for Italy. And Amaury Rivera preparing a probably double substitution. If he needs a taller block, but Bozio blocking this one strong.
Masterblock and set point for Italy.
The very first set point on Pedrali's serve, and she's serving well.
Set point, Italy.
Oh, this one. Great one by Zhang Yijun.
Belandi and not totally strong enough to play this one by Zhang Yijun.
Good reception, Belandi for Bozio. It's digged and covered, but it will not come back. Ceccatelli back in the front row, and Barrichelli about to serve from position 5. Another set point, the second one for Italy. Yeah, that's a blockout found by Tang Shumei, and the net fault by Eva Ceccatelli. And Tang Shumei is ready to serve. Belandi for Cecatelli, but this one is dig. A strong one. It's out of bounds.
And a serve set point for Italy.
And we know how good Belandi is able to serve. Free ball for Italy. Is this the option? Pirelli blocked.
Cover by Biasi. Oh, it's too long for Riva Cecatelli.
Oh, there was an option for Italy, but Belandi has this crucial back set at the moment in this point. 26-4. Pirelli just tipping it. Great fight. Option for China. And the blackout found by Wang Yanan.
It's a first set point for China now. Oh, what a thrilling first set.
Yu Hongqin is the ball to serve. And Pedrelli. The ball is back. A great option for China. And they find the blockout through Chui Xiao. Italy was so close, but this first set is for China. 1-0. And we were thinking, Ellen, we have plenty of time between game one and game two today. But if it goes this way for 3, 4 or more sets, we won't have a lot of break between this first game and the second one. Between France and the USA, it will be around 6 p.m. here in France.
May not have the time to take the little nap you were expecting for Julien.
We don't need any nap in such a great atmosphere, but the confirmation that Italy is a strong side this week.
And in this first set, they really pushed China to play their very best sitting volleyball to eventually.
If we see the same
first set, but it was
if we see the same level that China had against Canada in the first day and against Brazil in day two, normally they should be stronger than Italy. But Italy is fighting with such a great team spirit.
Chinese players may be a little tired physically and mentally after the intense battle yesterday night versus USA, because they played the last game yesterday. They have to play the first one today, plus a little bit earlier than the other day, just to give the opportunity to the pupils cheering in the stands to attend this sitting volleyball game.
Well, which is a good news for the Chinese fans back home, because it's not the middle of the night and they can assist to this game. This game of day four, and China will be back on court tomorrow at 6 p.m. here against France, the host nation, before the big final on Sunday.
Allez, je vous entends encourager les deux équipes, l'italienne et chinoise. Allez, Italie!
What an amazing first set we have here in Vendôme. 28-26.
Allez,
this set went to China.
No substitution for China and no substitution for Italy.
Both teams were close, but Amaury Ribeiro is thinking about this double substitution with Eliza Spediacci and Julia Aringieri, which will mean Sarah she really has to leave the field because of this VS2 rule.
But she really did great back row as well as at the net, so it was a good set from Cirelli again.
First point to Italy.
And the first point of this second set is for Italy. Find Flavia Barrigelli. Yeah, she was at the right place, Flavia Barrigelli, but unable to dig it in the right direction.
Service to China, number one.
Tang Xiumei for her first serve in the second set. Oh, Cirelli finds a solution. She's not only a great middle blocker when she's sitting at the front, but also able to spike it behind the 2 meter line. This reception as to awkward for China.
To Michel asking for the bumper once again, taking this time just to ask her teammates to move a little bit to change their reception position.
Oh, what a block once again by Sara Cirelli.
They wait a little bit between having Aringieri coming on the court. Cirelli is really doing great. And again, a winning block for the Italian number 7.
That's already a 5-1 lead for Italy. And Xu Yumin holds the first time out. The question was to know if Italy was able to have a great reaction. The answer is yes.
Oh, you guys are bien dans les tribunes. 5 pour Italy, 1 point pour l'équipe chinoise dans ce deuxième set.
Italy ranked 7th, only in 2017 for their very first European Championship. They were second 2 years later and got then their qualification for Tokyo in 2023. They won the European Championship at home. So indeed, they are getting better year after year, match after match.
Solid spike by Sui Xiao. To give the second point of the set to China. Cirelli sending this free ball to China. Very good spike once again. And Silvia Biasi unable to dig it. Just too quick. Belandi for Bozio. Oh, this ball was for you, Ellen. They wanted to warm you up for the game of France later today against the USA. And we got a question on the live stream of the ball, because we can see this World Power Volley logo on the volleyball. It's exactly the same ball than in regular volleyball. Only the logo is changing, but it's the same ball, same weight, everything is the same. Set by the black. That's just an unforced error by Roberta Pedrelli. Good reception. The Lambi moving just a bit. Pedrelli blocked. And Chiré is scoring another one.
Good distribution by Julia Belandi. The immediate answer by China. Only Wang King serving. Wang Yanan also on a very quick set.
And Zhang Xufei has the opportunity to bring China back in the game in the second one. Good serve.
That fall by Italy, but I was amazed by the way Yu Hongqing came from back row to the net to take the set.
And it's all Italy led 5 points to one in this second set, and it's now 8-0. So Amaury Ribeiro has to find something, to adjust something. Especially in reception, because Zhang Xufei is serving well. The reason why this game is played earlier today is to have all the school kids in the stand, to have this great atmosphere around sitting volleyball. And that's a great block.
Stop block, yeah, by Zhang Bijun.
Zhang Xufei carrying on. What a point by Francesca Bozo. A true technical leader on court. Really blocked,
that fault. Call again, Wang Yanan. Wang Yanan just told her coach that yes, she touched the net. Don't waste a video challenge on it.
This one is just over the block. Mostly by Wang Yanan. Good dig, but the transition set is not in the right area. And that's an 11th point for China. Or a 10th one.
Yeah.
10-0.
10-0, yep. Yeah.
Yeah. No chance for Roberta Pedrelli to bring this ball back in play. And this time, it stands 11-10 for China. Yeah, it was a bit to the inside, but Flavia Barrageli managed this one.
Yeah, it was a catch by Sandy Jude.
Perfect reception.
I think it's touch, yeah. And no, says well, Flavia Barrageli.
Everyone is saying no. And Amore Ribeiro will ask for a video challenge on this one. Is it the first one of the game?
Oh, yeah. I think so.
Probably need some time for Pierre Clabat to warm up the engine.
Whether Flavia Barrageli touched his ball or not. And then the official answer.
It doesn't look like this.
Difficult to say whether this little finger was just very close to the ball.
There are some discussions.
Official decision is that there is no black touch and the point is for Italy.
This one was close. Is this little finger being touched or not? It's a question of the number of images you can get on this video challenge.
Very nice first end for Yuan Qing. And 12-all, yeah. This match is still very tight.
Barrageli with her number 8. A deep serve, a very good one, and that's an ace. For this 33-year-old player.
And the ball is out.
It was close for Eva Cecatelli, but clearly on the wrong side of the line. Catello is a great spike. Good reception from the middle. Biasi will dig. And Bozio looks quite the same. Oh, this time is touched by the line.
No, I think. So we mean we'll take the video challenge and maybe the point could be given back to China.
challenge video for China.
I mean, in live, I was thinking this one was just out by Francesca Boggio, but it goes so quick. It's sometimes very close when it's just a very small finger. Everyone is waiting for its image.
No block touch. And Yuan King serving for China. Good reception by Biazi. And this time it remains in the net for Francesca Boggio.
That is really close. There is quite no difference between both teams since the beginning of the game. Locatelli. No block out. This one is blocked by the net. That's 16 for China, 15 for Italy. About to catch ball against Italy. That's a 2-point lead now for China.
Time out to Italy. The score.
And time out for Italy, because Amaury Ribeiro feels it's an important moment to close this gap and to stay in contention with China.
Yeah, Italy was 2 points ahead, they are now 2 points back.
Yeah, just to remember you, both China and Italy had 6 points in this current ranking after day three. So today's winner in this one will be at least second tonight, depending on the result of the USA, but they play against France at 6 p.m. So they should normally be able to win 3 points. If you weren't with us just before, sitting volleyball is pretty recent, especially for the women team in France. And they're just working on their game regarding the Paralympics.
Really asking for a lifting. Regularly, you can check if there was a lifting or there is a block.
Yeah, Italy probably asked for a block then. Because the lifting is so subjective that you have to see it live. I can compare it to, you know,
I think it's only possible when the ball is touched by the block, so you can have the image of the precisely of the contact with the ball and see maybe if the player's back touches the ground at the same time. But anyway, I think it's for a block touch that Ribeiro called.
Judging a lifting in city volleyball is almost the same than judging, you know, the walking on road if they are touching the floor at the same time. When you go very, very slow on the movement, you can see that they lose contact with the floor, but it's the normal live view that counts in this decision. Amaury Ribeiro.
But there can't be any lifting if you don't touch the ball anyway, so it was definitely for a block touch. And
block touch,
even with the images, it's quite difficult to know whether it's touch or not. And yes, said Pierre Cobalch.
Yeah, even Tirelli is surprised. She was like, let's ask. It's already 18 to 15. But that's a winner on this video challenge for Italy. And it changed almost everything because it's now 16 for Italy and 17 for China. Great fight by the Italian side. And this time, Xu Xiao bringing this point to an end. Well done by Tirelli.
Great play again by the Italian setter. As the ball went towards Tirelli's left shoulder, so she could escape from the Chinese blockers.
Yeah, this dig by Bolgio is just not good enough to allow Picatelli to try this one back. Great cover by Biasi. And this one is in the court, and that's a 3-point lead now for China, 28-17. And it's well deserved. But they're playing really good. Then on there is Barry Jelly. Wang Yanan. And that's a great moment to score another one.
Wang Yanan, not the tallest player on the court and playing well. Just hitting towards the top to take some fingers of the Italian blockers and find a blockout.
Okay, by Tirelli once again. And she's now serving. Also well done by Zhang Lijun. And this double substitution comes now for Italy. It's Pagliacci coming in for Tirelli. And Aringhieri in for Barrichelli. Italy is still hoping to change things in this second one. That's a strong one by Aringhieri, coming in and scoring on her first block, both at.
Yes, Pagliacci could possibly play as a libero as well. So she's a gracious player, back row. And we know how Julia Aringhieri is good at the net.
Well done by Bozio. This one works so good for Italy. This soft touch in the middle. She's just faking a strong spike and then having something just in between a tip and a soft spike. Aringhieri. Two block attacks and 2 points for the Italian number 12. Italy is only one behind.
And definitely a smart coaching by Amaro Ribeiro, the Brazilian coach of this Italian team.
That's a free ball for Italy. Belandi tried it in on the second set. And good spike by Tang Shimei. And it will be a special game for Amaury Ribeiro tomorrow, because he will be playing against Brazil, his home country.
Oh, misunderstanding between Spediacci and Biasi.
And the scoreboard is not updating on your screen, but it's 24-21, a scoreboard, a set point now for China.
And Shuri Xiao got surprised by this ball coming to her. And she totally missed her set. So the first set ball is saved by Italy.
Yeah, don't take care of the scoreboard you see on the screen. We'll do this live for you. 24 for China, 22 for Italy.
And Cirelli and Bergeri are back on the court for the second set point.
Thanks, Shimei, to close this one.
Nothing to do on this strong hit by Tang Shumei, the best backer of Tokyo Paralympic Games, who easily see why on this last spike.
And that's a 2-0 lead for China. But we're experiencing really a great game here.
C'est un des grands classiques. Attention, elle est pour vous. Ça arrive. Attention, ça va être à vous. À gauche, à droite, au milieu, tous avec nous. Vous avez le droit de lever les mains, les enfants, hein, les mains. Hein. Attention.
And while the coaches are wondering which starting six they will put on court, the speaker is playing with the kids.
Attention!
And a famous song here in Vandeuve.
And the Italian therapist is taking care of Sarah Cirelli, right shoulder.
Yeah, he already worked on Cicatelli's back at the end of the first set.
Well, sitting volleyball is very physically exacting discipline. You may think just because you're sitting on the floor that it's quite cool. Definitely not. Set 0 for China, 28-26, 25-22, but from what we saw from the beginning, Italy really have the level to take at least one set. Will they be able to keep this level of performance in the third set?
Cirelli is back, Baricelli is back. For sure on the Chinese side there is no reason to change anything. But even if it was close, China is leading 2-0.
Attention, on est reparti, on tend les mains tout le monde. Allez,
and only one thing will be sure tonight. If USA is able to win against France with a 3-point victory, they will be the big fella on Sunday, and they will remain undefeated. This will be the next game we'll have here in Vandeuve at 6 p.m. This first point of the third set for China. Oh, Tang Chumei, touched by Bozio. But then Silvia Biasi cannot react.
It's very difficult when the block just touched the serve.
Lucky one for Ceccatelli, but it counts as a point with the help of the net. Ceccatelli trying to find the block out. And Cirelli closing this one.
Close the solidity.
And she's impressive at the net. This comeback wasn't the cleanest one for Pedrelli. That's the third point for China with Liu Hongqin. That's by the luck. This serve is played by Captain Francesca Bozio.
To follow.
It wasn't the best reception for Tang Chumei. She's able to do much better. That's a strong one by Wang Yiman. As we already mentioned, not the tallest player on court, but able to spike it so hard in the right area. Ready, and the block is whistled for lifting. Sang Shufei, too much energy on this one.
But that's difficult, but just putting your arms up with the movement, it's quite easy to have the bat off the ground.
That was a technical one from Ceccatelli. It's well read by China, but not enough to send the ball on the other side of the net.
And once again in this set, Italy is giving half time to the Paralympic silver medalist.
Another great effort behind his serve line by Ceccatelli.
Michelle organizing the reception on her side.
She liked this little one to position four there. And a 2 point lead for Italy early in this third set.
Oh, great save by Biasi, and again.
Yeah, Pedrelli touched this one at least two times, and that's not too much.
Liu Hongqing wasn't fast enough to avoid this ball.
Yeah, she was just sitting in the line. And that's a point for Bo Zhou, and she's smiling because she knows it was a flyer. Sara Cirelli.
Luck is part of the game sometimes.
It is. Good one. Pedrelli as hard as she can. And a blackout on Zhang Yijun. That was close by Belandi, but great effort by Zhang Yijun. Nothing is decided in this third set. China is leading 2-0. But now 2 behind this one. Great dig.
Oh,
there was a one-hand dig. Barrichelli blocked by China. She had just a wall in front of her.
Great action from both teams. Super spike by Xu Yixiao. Super dig by Francisca Bozio.
Once again, great block. Good blackout done by Tang Xumei.
And once again, China is back.
Nine-all. And it's only the first game of this day four here in Vendeuve. Cirelli. Good spike, and Barrichelli fighting well at the net. Good serve by Pedrelli. Good spike and an amazing block by Belandi. And another one-hand dig by Wang Yanan. But this one is going far away from the limit of the field. A very small gap for Italy. Only a 2 points lead. It's clearly not enough when you see that it's only 11-9 in the second one, in the third one, sorry. Free ball for China. She's ready for the dig. And Bozio to score this one. What a teamwork.
Definitely Bozio knows how to score points without choosing power.
And with this 3 points lead for Italy, Xu Yimin, China's head coach, forced to call a timeout. Can Italy take a set against China? That's the question of the next 15 minutes. They are leading by three, but that's not a lot when you saw what happened yesterday in Sitting Volleyball. You can lead 24-18 and still lose the set.
Position fault signaled by Emma Votarić, the second referee.
And that's the first time in the week that we see such a position mistake. Fine, one of the good servers of this tournament, Zhang Yijun. He's always taking a lot of time to figure out where to serve. Just in between Cerreri and Pedrelli. Bozio with the blackout. She's so important.
She doesn't always use power, but when it's needed, she can also do so. Just out of bounds for Flavia Baricelli.
Reception is too bad for Silvia Biasi. No teammate can help her on this one. And the line of the serve was very interesting by Zhang Xumei. And now Amaury Ribeiro is also taking his time out. China is fighting back. 14 for Italy, 12 for China. This atmosphere already feels like a Paralympic Games one. There will be a big crowd there out in Paris, in the Paris North Arena, for this sitting volleyball event. And that's also something you have to get used to. All this atmosphere, this pressure, and that's an awesome point for China and Shui Xiao. Even a lot of players on court already knows what it feels to be at the Paralympics. Oh, Tecatelli finding this block out.
So did the ball touch the antenna after the ends of the block? Or before? Before, said Gigi Prieto, the US referee. And so Amaury Ribeiro is asking for a block touch.
We'll
have a new video challenge.
Did they whistle the antenna touch? Or did they just say it was out?
Just said I would, but I think if you see, maybe touch after.
Emma Brotaj was
the antenna.
Asking if he wanted to know if there was an antenna touch or a block touch.
Well, I think it's exactly at the same time.
Antenna first.
It's definitely antenna first. So the point is for China.
Yeah. And that's 14-0. Such an unpredictable third set. So were the first two ones. Zhang Xumei. Yeah, we can probably stop the challenge music now. So the game is underway. And that's a 15th point for China. China Khanna is just playing better currently with some better serve. And the Italian reception is struggling. Even this one from Biasi is good. Belandi, a second time, a third time.
And the third one, yeah, was the good one. Great. I think it was unproposed that the first ball went to Cirelli, so Giulia Belandi could spike.
Yeah, it's a good position for her on position two. Reception and well played by Bozo. Yeah. It wasn't what we learned at school in volleyball, but that's still a point.
But reading of the game is amazing.
Good day again. We know Italy is playing very well soccer, but too hard this one for Sara Cirelli. Ciccatori, well played. Nothing decided in the third set, 17-0. And China has to take care of this tactical one that she has in store. The Zhang Yijun is in position there, close to position four. China. Elandi moving fast. Barrichelli just too low. For Cirelli, just a missed spike once again. And China now has.
Wang Yan just put her hands away.
2.6.
Cirelli trying to block out.
19 for China, 17 for Italy. Cirelli setting for Barrichelli. Bozio with the help of the net. A lucky one once again to stay in contention.
It's Sara Cirelli, definitely very good hands on. Is actually playing also as a second setter.
Oh, what a serve by Sara Cirelli to equalize this one.
Not unhappy on this one because the ball could as well remain in her own side.
And the double substitution for Italy is now coming. The one we already saw in the previous set, Elisa Spagiacci and Giulia Aringieri are in, both for Cirelli and Barrichelli.
Another good receiver and a good attacker.
Belandi for Aringieri. And it's enough to score a 20 point.
And we are on for her again, a very interesting money time in this third set.
20-0. Roberta Pedrelli. That's a great one. It looks in, even if Tamori Ribeiro He's requesting a video challenge. I was quite sure it was in. But the Italian bench is pretty sure it's out. Could be close. From my point of view, it was in. Not even on the line, just.
I had the impression also that it was in. But, oh yeah, it's clearly in.
All the good news of this one, Ellen, is we do not have to check our eyes now.
I was not quite sure, because regularly when I see something, it's just the reverse.
Now that's when we are doing some betting together, trying to figure out who will win. It's always the opposite that happens.
Zhangli Jun. Oh, great serve. And great job by Biazzi to save this ball first time. But that wasn't enough to prevent China from managing a mini break.
22 to 20. China is only 3 points away from winning this fourth stage game. They won their first game this week against Canada, 3-0, and a victory against Brazil, 3-1. They eventually lost yesterday night against the USA, 3-1, and they're about to win this one against Italy. And stay with us today. We have two more games going on later at 6 p.m. in exactly 2 hours, France against the USA. And then at 8 p.m., Canada against Brazil for a big clash of Pan-American sitting volleyball. And the 23rd point is for China. They need only two more. It's a great server, Zhangli Jun. Those are below the net level. And that's now four match points. But just before this double substitution again for Italy.
Italia
number 8, Flavia Baricelli out, and the
number 12, Giulia Aguirre. 24-20,
match point for China.
The Italia team.
Italy is still alive in this match.
Yeah, 3 points deficit, but we know Baricelli is not the best server of the team. She will have to do the job perfectly. A tactical one to position one. Oh, a miscommunication between Baricelli and Cirelli. And that's a victory for China. Well, 3-0, but nothing easy for China in this first game of day four here in Valdev. A great fight for Italy, and that's a victory for China. And this means at the ranking that China now has 9 points, 3 victories in 4 games. The USA also have 9, but they will play later against France. Italy is 3rd with 6. Brazil and Canada, 4th and 5th with 3 points, and France is currently 6th with no point won in this competition. We had a very lovely first game here for this day four of the Women's Super Six. We see you in exactly 2 hours, Ellen, for the second game of the day. It will be the clash between France and the USA. Stay with us. Bye-bye.
Je vous rappelle à 18h, le prochain match, les enfants, vous êtes invités cordialement avec vos parents. l'entrée est gratuite. Donc à 18h, le prochain match, c'est l'équipe de France.